Okay, so where are we today? We are actually rebuilding the pavilion, Dutch pavilion of the 1939. Let me quickly put it up for you so you can have a quick look at that too. World's Fair. This is the pavilion, and I'm integrating this into the scene because it's a heritage piece. So combining the heritage of this World's Fair that my grandfather has worked on creating, the Dutch pavilion, with the, let me switch on the lights here. So just built this in Blender. It's very coarse, as you can see. Separated out some things, and then we have the main kind of scene. Import that into Unity. I mean, seriously, Unity is just amazing. And then a quick bake will give us this kind of suspended. I should probably go to the other side. I'm not quite sure what's happening on the edge. That's the glass. I have glass in there. Gives us this suspended view. And then the idea is obviously that you can hop from, you know, panel to panel to panel, and then go into this kind of museum arena here with some space for some sculptures, maybe a hanging object here. My normals are flipped, so that I fixed that already. This is stretched, but that needs to be UV mapped kind of still. But you get a nice flavor of that, and then you can hang out here. So I'll put some chairs here. And actually, it's funnily enough, there's a shader in there that's actually glass shader. Look at this, there's some refraction going on there. I'm sure that cannot be run currently. But yeah, this is the idea. And then next to that, we go back down. There will be so you have a space here, you can hang in. For instance, one big whale of an object in the middle as a museum, and then there will be video walls. And the big goal will be to keep everything under the limit of the size, which will be a huge challenge. So later I will start reducing things. But then we of course still have the LiDAR that will be cut, and all of this according to a sprint. So I only have very little time, so I have to be very efficient. Okay, done, dusted, that's built, that's in. Now the next part will be the glass house. We've got glass, the space, we've got the space, the stairs. So the stairs will literally just be like this, these floating, as you can see again, the baking takes care of the light, which I think is the magic here, is the baking. That literally makes this happen. Let me hit play real quick so you can actually see the fireplace again. We have to reduce the amount of particles in the fireplace heavily. That's way too much now, as you can see. But it gives you that, even in most minimal form, it will give you a little bit of that flavor of fun. All this, these polygons will be trimmed. And yeah, as you can see, it'll just be a question of finalizing the build. So that's the glass house. Boom, done. LiDAR, clean up. Go to that, immediately clean it up and test it. Immediately see if it's under the size limit. Glass material, concrete, wood, just pick like 3-4 materials and that's it. These rocks might also be sacrificed later on. Look at the light, I mean, hitting these metal Archviz Pro models, right? If you have the reflection probes on, you can get really nice effects. So hit the reflection probes after you've been baking. And the haze is obviously a little bit of fog, so there's a small hint of fog on there. And then next, once we have the materials, we bake, see if we need to buy some materials, then we go into soundscape, just a couple of, just a gramophone with some records, just sample it and loop it real quickly, put some really heavy reverb effects on that, of course. 3 video walls with extremely lightweight looping animation, could be anything. I'm just going to grab something because for now I'm just placeholder for next Wednesday. And then maybe in Gravity Sketch make a whale or an example thing that floats. Then we've done the lighting, we'll do the composition, baking, compiling, test it a few times until we can get to the 180 megabytes. Keep a list, an error list of the question, the things that go wrong or the things that you need to learn. So there will be things that you just need to pick up. Like every project, There's like five things that I'm discovering, learning on the way immediately while we're building. When I'm doing Blender, every time I almost have to reinvent how to work with Blender, how to set up the lighting, but just have consistency across the software, because to be fair, a lot of the software is similar. So you can crack the nut on all software, and that's the learning aspect of this. This is a horribly, look at how horribly crude this file is. But at the end of the day, you import it in Unity and boom, it looks surprisingly good. So also surprise yourself with results. So go very quickly to the result, because then you're actually inspired to go on, right? This is like, wow, I can see myself. There's some flip normals here. I mean, I'm constantly puzzling to figure this stuff out, right? Use assets, use a couple of well-placed assets that you can borrow and are officially have paid for and have licensed to use. I'm sure the guys of Archviz Pro will be delighted. Then you've got sound. Then the theme, architectural theme, is combining my uncle's antiques that we will integrate in there and then go LiDAR scanning next summer. We'll have the real objects. We'll have the mirrored metaverse or NFT objects that we can then combine. So we will create an NFT gallery of a real cultural piece of heritage. That's the theme here. We're bringing the culture into the metaverse to relive the memories. So it's about memories, creation, and perform. And then the pavilion of Opa, Grandpa, of a very famous Dutch architect, but he was part of the project. And then it's boom, compile, freeze, clean up. Test, and obviously I don't think it's going to look extremely good on this online web, open web GL stuff. It doesn't look too good. Of course this light won't be happening like this. This will likely be a scaled version of this, right? So something like that, as you can see there. And save everything in the Unity folder. So if you do save things in the Unity folder, then you can immediately test things. So yeah, this is the scene so far. I just want to share a little bit the thinking so that we, for instance, this chair, right? Duplicate, move up. And then you learn these little tricks from each other. Like the other day I learned this trick where the V, it's a known thing, but for most people, but maybe not for everybody, is the V, hello, give me a piece of geometry, will snap to, there you go, a piece of geometry. So that will easily, and then F centers it. I mean, seriously, yeah, question, do we need to learn that stuff? Yeah, because if you're doing 10 different pieces of software per day, you do need to learn that stuff again, because you can master a lot of pieces of software. A lot of things are common, but the shortcuts is a challenge anyway. Bit of a ramble, but it's supposed to be a work in progress sharing of the philosophy and the sprint of this week. And obviously I forgot to put on the Blade Runner music in the background, so we'll update more on Sunday or something like that with the next version. Ciao from the metaverse, the real meta. This is the where we want to hang out with our pipe. So I just talked to a friend yesterday, chatting about this. I'm like, this is the space where if we die, we go to heaven. This is where we want to hang out in space. It's a beautiful, we can smoke our pipe. It needs a hammock. His suggestion was add a hammock. Jonathan's suggestion is good. We definitely need to hang out here at the fireplace. More fireplaces that are virtual. Do we need virtual fireplaces? Or is it a fakery? Well, in this case, because we're doing the LiDAR, it makes sense in this setting to present it like that. Obviously, I don't know if this is going to be a final piece or not. So with that, I sign off, and I'm glad the pavilion is taking some shape, some form or another. More to follow later. So like and subscribe on the meta.